The US administration today announced that the sanctions which were put in place for Iran will come into effect on the 2nd of May, even for those countries which had been given a conditional waiver to import Iranian oil for 6 months. So this news was expected for some time, but what it has done is that for countries such as India, which have been hugely dependent on Iranian oil, will need to get to alternate sources of supplies at competitive terms as those offered by Iran, be it in terms of costing, pricing or logistics. So it's a very tough spot for India to be in, specifically at a time when the ongoing elections to choose the 17th Lok Sabha are on. President Trump believes that such sanctions will have a major impact on the Iranian nuclear program, given that this also comes at a time when the Iranian presidential guard, the Revolutionary Guards, have been termed as a terrorist organization as well. The US government believes that, and the US administration believes at this point of time, that such sanctions will choke off all funding to the Iranian state in terms having precisely dealing a death blow to the nuclear program. In fact, the stock markets have already taken a beating. This has been a huge fall. But these are more to do on the stock part of it. When we look at the macro and the major issues that the Indian government must be contemplating at this point of time is to impress upon a country such as Saudi Arabia or United Arab Emirates to increase supply. Now, it's not very easy to find the same quantum of oil at the rates which were offered by Iran. And given that Iran was under sanctions, India was able to get oil at very competitive rates. This also comes at a time when OPEC has reduced supplies, and whatever OPEC does, there's OPEC plus one, so Russia has been towing OPEC's line as well. This leaves India with little room to maneuver. Also, there are sanctions on PDVSA, which is a state-owned company of Venezuela. So there is only so much oil out there. While supply may not be much of an issue, the price at which India will be able to get this oil will be something that everyone would be looking out for. The short-term supply situation will still be able to, I'm sure Indian planners will be able to get through that. The larger issue at stake here is what happens in situations like this, what is our domestic production up to? India needs to get its domestic crude oil production and domestic energy production story right. It's absolutely for a country of size like India. India is the world's third largest oil importer, and the larger mandate out there given by the present NDA government has been to reduce oil imports. This can only happen by taking measures on both the supply side and demand side as well. To increase supply side, to resolve the supply side problems, the no-brainer answer is that obviously our state-owned companies such as ONGC or oil, or even the private companies like Cain, need to up their production. On the demand side, we have been looking at things like ethanol blending, which hasn't worked out to the level that we would have so desired. So it's not a very easy spot for a country like India to be in. We are the third largest oil supplier. However, India has been exploring a kind of a consumers collective for some time now for, say, major buyers like China, Japan, Korea, or India come together, and then they kind of try to get better contracts from West Asian suppliers like Saudi Arabia or other Gulf nations. But we are still some time away from that. These are larger geopolitical issues that need to be resolved, and there has to be some kind of a consensus among the buyers nation. Interestingly, this comes at a time when a lot of producing countries have been looking at major markets like India to establish a presence here. Perhaps India would like to piggyback on that sentiment.